Welcome back to the channel, guys, and today I'm going to be starting a new what if. What if Deku was a Saiyan? Yes, guys, just hear me out for this one. What if Deku was a Saiyan? This is going to be pretty interesting. Just watch it and comment down below what you think of it. And subscribe if you're new. If you're a new subscriber, comment down below and tell me. I love to interact and talk to you guys. I love your guys' funny comments and everything. So comment down below and talk to me, okay? And tell me what you think of this what ifs in the comment. Yeah, tell me what you think of this. This is gonna be part one, guys. Tell me what you think of it. And get it to about 80 likes so I can know you guys are interested in seeing part two. So without further ado, let's get straight into it. Start the intro. Was having a bad day. He was having a bad day. This was the day everything was going to change, but he was having a bad day. This was the day when Bakugo burned his notebook and Deku decided to take a shortcut home, but he ended up getting trapped by the slug within All Might save him. After meeting All Might, All Might tell him everything about the wound. After Deku grabbed onto him and the slug villain bottle dropped and the slug villain got free. So in this one, All Might is gonna tell Deku that he couldn't become a hero. He cannot become a hero without a quirk. He can either become a policeman or a firefighter. They risk their life and save normal people, so we can pick one of those normal jobs, but hero thing was not gonna work out for him. Deku ran off the rooftop. He ran off the rooftop and went down there. He just ran off the rooftop after feeling so heartbroken and shame. He ran off the rooftop and went down. All Might knew that he might have just crushed this kid's dream, but he knew he had to tell him the truth or he will sometime risk his life and know that this kid couldn't fight any real villains. Until Deku was walking and he heard some commotion and his body moved on pure instinct, and he went over there to saw the slow villain, and Deku realized that it is all his fault because All Might must have dropped the villain when he grabs onto him. And All Might was at the back of the crowd and a lady cried out, "Where is All Might? The heroes need his help because these heroes cannot stop this monster." All Might was at the back of the crowd clutching his chest and he realized that his time is up and he cannot do nothing. The mount lady couldn't stop the villain because she couldn't get through that path because it was kind of closed up and she didn't want to risk end up hurting anyone in the process. So after the slug villain turned around, Deku could see the face of his someone who he think that was his friend, but Bakugo hate him because Bakugo treat him like nothing because he was worthless and he was quirkless, and Bakugo was so angry to find out that Deku was going to UA too. But on pure instinct, Deku's body started to buff. Yes, his body started, his veins started to pump up, he started to feel muscle all over his body. He didn't feel strained, it feels so natural, and he's trying to figure out what is this power. He rushed towards it and Deku fling this book bag right into the villain's eyes and he grabs his fist and punched the slug villain about 50 meters away, and he's looking at his hands and realizing, what the hell is this? After Bakugo catches breath and got free, he said, what are you doing here? But Deku didn't reply. His body started to move on pure instinct as well, as the slug villain started to run towards him and said, "I'm going to kill you, kid." And Deku started running towards him with pure instinct. Deku doesn't even know how his body is moving like this. The slug villain run towards Deku. Deku run towards him with a supernatural speed. Deku couldn't believe that he's doing this because all of his life he's been quirkless. Deku give the slug villain an uppercut that sent a shockwave breaking some mirrors around them and pushing the people behind him a little bit farther. The shockwave was so powerful with just one uppercut. After smashing that slug villain, Deku turned around with tears forming his eyes, and he looks at Bakugo with a huge smile and said, "Bakugo, I couldn't just stand there and watch you die." All Might was so in shock because this was the quirkless kid that asked him a minute ago if he could be a hero without a quirk and how did he defeat that villain. But he still felt shame that that kid without a quirk tried everything and risked his life and he was just standing here like a bystander. Now Deku is looking at Bakugo and he didn't realize that the slow villain has reformed his shape, and he was starting to charge at Deku and said, "No, I am done playing with you. I'm going to finish you off once and for all." All Might clutches his chest as he decided to get mad and said, "No, I have to push past my limits." And Deku Arm, one of the pro heroes, said, "Save the boy, this thing is gonna kill him." Deku wasn't in fear. Deku was ready to counter because Deku feels something inside of him, like some new hope or some spirit of power that he didn't really understand. So he stands his ground, but a huge explosion dropped right in front of him, causing Deku to cover his eyes. As Deku opened his eyes, he heard the word, "I am really pathetic, huh, kid?" And Deku looks up to saw All Might. He blocked the slug villain attack. Deku looks up at All Might with pure flurry and happiness in his eyes, even though All Might just told him that he couldn't become a hero. All Might looks at Deku and said, "Don't worry, kid. I've sent this word many times, but everything will be okay now because I am here." Bakugo and Deku watch in pure shock and amazement as All Might uses one hand to lift the slow villain up in the air. He said, "Pros are always risking their life. That is the true work of a pro hero." As blood starts spewing out of his mouth because he was pushing himself past his limit. The slug villain got pissed and said, "Damn you, All Might," as he was trying to slap All Might with some weird tentacles, but All Might grasped back his fist and yelled out, "Detroit Smash!" as the slug villain exploded in a million pieces. Everyone behind All Might was blown away by the fury of that punch. All Might turned around to face everyone as everyone was cheering at him and was in pure amazement as the clouds started to apart and the weather started to change, and Death Arm, the pro hero, looks up and said, "Holy crap, he changed the weather," as rain started to pour down. After that, the rest of the heroes collected a small amount of sludge so he couldn't reform himself, and he went into police custody, and lots of news cameras were there. They all wanted to speak to All Might. Deku got chewed out by all the heroes that was there and said, "What if All Might didn't show up? You would have been killed, kid, but you were pretty brave to try and risk your life to save your little friend." After all that passed, everything cleared up and sunset came, and Deku was off to went home, but he wanted to apologize to All Might for messing up everything and allowing the slow villain to get away. But All Might was swarmed by paparazzi and everything, so Deku couldn't even get close towards him. Deku didn't want to interrupt, so he decided to went home because he was also feeling very tired after fighting that sludge villain. He was feeling very sleepy and wanted to take a nap. He was trying to figure out what the hell did he did back there, because where that amount of power and force came from. It was like his body was moving on his own. He said to himself, he was wondering, was it a quirk or something? It didn't feel human, but it felt natural. It felt almost like a primal power, that he was the first time he was using it and he was experiencing this power, but it was already a part of him, because when he used it, it feel like it belonged this way. And it also felt like he knew how to fight, the way he was dodging and counteracting the slug villain. But it was the first time he wasn't really scared or nervous, but he didn't understand it. But he was cut off of his thinking when he heard someone said, "Deku." Deku turned around and saw Bakugo running up to him. Bakugo looks at Deku and grabs him by the shirt and said, "Look, I will never ask a weakling like you to help me. Don't you look down on me, okay? You got that? I was just fine by myself. You're just a quirkless failure who won't even cut it as a police officer. You didn't help me. You did nothing. Okay? Don't forget that. I don't owe you anything, Deku," as he said while he walks off. Deku's sweat dropped as he thought in his head, what the hell was that? But then he thought to himself, Bakugo was right. It's not like I defeated the villain. Guess I should get back to stop following and quitting my dreams. He said all this as he began to walk back to his house. Then, Deku heard something dropping from the sky. It was All Might jumping from the All Reporters and said, "I am here," as he dropped right in front of Deku. "All Might, why are you here? How did you get rid of all those reporters?" Deku said. Before he could even say anything, he was cut off because his transformation time wore out and he was transformed back into his skinny self and blood spewed from his lips. "Young man," All Might looks at him and said, "I came here to thank you and also discuss your question from earlier. If you hadn't told me about your life, or if you hadn't run into that fight to save that boy, I would be back of the crowd watching all of this fight go on and watch that boy get killed. But you gave me the inspiration. You, without a quirk, run in and risk your life to save that kid. And I was just standing there when I am the symbol of hope and peace and justice, and I did nothing. But because of you, I get the inspiration and the courage to stop that monster, so thanks." Then Deku looks at All Might and looked back down at his feet and said, "No, it's all my fault anyway. I got in the way of your hard work. I wasted your energy and wasting your time on your buff form, so I was responsible for all of this." All Might looks at him and said, "I am not done. You told me you didn't have a quirk, but when I saw you in action, you as a quirkless boy, run to save your friend and risk your life. And I, with all much these powers, stood there in the crowd. So that was the thing that gave me the push to push past my limits. So you're the reason why your friend is safe today." Deku gasped as he began to process the words All Might, the number one hero, his idol, just said to him. Then All Might looks down at Deku and said, "There are stories about heroes and how they become great because the first thing happened was their body moved before they could even think about anything else, because that is a true reason and the responsibility of being a hero. Your body has the instinct to save your friend even though you thought in your mind it was hopeless, but your body moved on itself to save him. So, you can become a hero." Deku start clutching his chest and crying after hearing these words. These words from the most popular hero in the world, the number one hero, and the someone he wants to become like when he grow up. So, Deku ignored all of the bullying and the people that call him useless and he cannot become a hero. And All Might decided to tell him that he can inherit his quirk from him. So this part is going to play out very similar like the anime. Yeah, All Might's going to explain to him all about his quirk. Deku stopped crying. And All Might explained everything and asked him, "Do you want my power? Do you want to inherit my quirk?" Deku has a big smile on his face right now when he heard those words. Deku decided to accept. So everything played out similar like in the anime. After Deku decided to accept it, All Might asked him, "So, can you might explain those moves you pulled off against the slug villain? You lied to me or something? I thought you'd tell me that you were quirkless. I never seen a normal human being move like that with such strength and skill and abilities. It's like you were fighting as an experienced fighter and it seemed like you knew what you were doing." Deku waved his hands around in panic. No, I'm quirkless. I do not know what happened back there. It was the first time my body was feel like it was moving on its own. Trust me, All Might, I really do not know what happened back there. I have never seen this ability and power yet before, but it feels like I was used to it, and it was a hidden quirk that my body just needed to accept it, like it was there all along, but this was the first time I was using it. All Might decided to take this in perspective and said that it might be a hidden quirk and he needs to keep his eyes on it. Maybe it was just a waking, because Deku was met with a life or death situation of his friend going to be killed, or if he could use his quirk to save his own, to save his life. Okay kid, we will talk about this later, so get some rest. Go home because it's getting late, and you get 2 days of rest, because after that it will be nothing than hard training. Deku said alright, and with that the two parted ways, and Deku went home. As Deku went home, he feels so tired, he decided to take a shower. As he went into the shower after saying good evening to his mother and said that he's home, he feels a slight bump right near to his butt. He must feel like it was a effects of fighting that slug villain. He brushed it off like it was nothing, and after finished showering, he went to bed immediately. As soon as he opened the door, he jumps on the bed, and about 3 seconds, he napped off. He wakes up the next morning. He felt weird. He got out of his bed and went to the bathroom. He felt like he was on stilts or something. He felt taller. He felt weird. His whole body feels full of energy. This was the first time he wakes up and feel this way. Also, he felt like something was attached to him, and his clothes felt really tight on him. When he reached the bathroom, his eyes widened in shock. When he looks in the mirror, he realized that his body has went through a complete change. He wasn't scrawny or anything. He was buff. Yes, he was buff with a six pack, and he was even taller. His shoulder was broad. He was now a young man. He was wondering in his head, what the hell is going on? There was no more baby fat in his face. He had cheekbones and sharp jaws. He was wondering what the hell is going on. How could he change this much overnight? His hair were longer, and it was more spiky and even darker. The greenish color was seemed to be fading. And then he moved and his shirt ended up ripping. His biceps were huge. He was like a muscle bodybuilder, and he was wondering what the hell is really going on. This couldn't happen overnight. He started to stare in the mirror even more, and then he saw something at the corner of his eye catch his reflection. He saw something wagging, and he turned around to try and grab it, but when he turned, the thing moved with him. He was in complete shock and wondering what the hell is going on. He realized that he had a tail. Is he a monkey or something now? What in the world? Why do I have a monkey tail? And why do I look so different? Could this be my quirk? He asked himself. He closed his eyes and he concentrated. This feel like the same intense rush of power he felt yesterday when he went off against a slug villain. This feels like that same amount of power. But you do not understand. Why now? Why is it just activating now? And what really is it? Is it strength? Is it the monkey abilities or something? Because he has a tail like a monkey. Before he could think anything more, he was cut off when he heard a voice coming upstairs. Izuku, are you still sleeping? It is past noon already. His mother said as she walked into his room, but she realized that he wasn't there. Then she saw the bathroom door open and she decided to peek in there. And she saw a completely different boy. His hair was much darker. He had a monkey tail. He was pretty huge and he was much taller. Izuku? Honey, what happened to you? She asked in pure shock as she dropped something she was carrying in her arms. He looks at her with an even shocked expression on his face and said, Mom, I don't really know. I just wake up this way and I looked in the mirror and saw that maybe this was my quirk. My quirk was finally awakened. Deku looks at his mother as his tail began to swing to left and right. He was happy. She looked at him and realized the shirt was ripped, and she said, "Well, I'm going to go for some of your father's old clothes because they look like they can fit you now." After putting on some of his father's old clothes, he explained everything that happened to him yesterday to his mom about the slug villain and everything. But he didn't tell her the part where All Might picked him as his successor. His mother thought that his quirk was a bit strange. His father, that worked overseas, could breathe fire. And she could use telekinesis. I'm just gonna change up everything. She has a quirk to use telekinesis to move objects. And she thought that the child quirk would resemble either the mother or the father quirk. But in this case, Deku quirk is totally different from both of them combined. So he has a father in this one. There's a mention of his father, and his father's overseas working. Then she think to herself, so where in the world did that monkey tail come from? Nevertheless, she felt extremely happy for Deku because now he finally had a quirk and he didn't have to go through his whole life feeling depressed knowing that his mother and father has a quirk and he didn't have a quirk for himself. She thought to herself, he has a power and now he can completely follow his dream without she thinking of him getting hurt because he might have a powerful quirk because now he's built like a bodybuilder and he could take on and become the number one hero if he wanted to. She started to believe in his dreams even more. Aizuku, please be careful, honey. Don't hurt yourself testing out your new quirk, okay? And testing out your powers, don't do it inside the house and don't go out and hurt yourself. We do not know what kind of power lies inside of you. We do not want what happened to the slug villain happen again today. She was worried for the safety of her son. Don't worry, mom, I won't do something that stupid, he said as he ate his breakfast and went outside to test out his new quirk. He went outside and looked up in the air and tried if he could use back those moves when he did with the slow villain, and he said, okay, let's see how far I can jump. He sinks down into the ground and jumps straight up in the air as he was about 200 feet off the ground. He could see his neighbor's house and everything. He was really high. Then he started to yell out a scream. What the hell? Whoa, because he was falling with it. He was falling down with a lot of force. Then he shut his eyes and realized that he hasn't hit the ground yet. And then he looked at his feet and said, wait, why aren't I falling down? Then he realized that he's floating and he said, wait, can I fly too? This quirk is amazing, he said with shock as he started to spin through the air and flying through the air. He went down back to the ground and stepped on his 2 feet and said, this is amazing. Just what is this quirk? He went down and said, now, time for me to test out my strength. He then raised his arms up in the air and punched the ground with so much force that it was meant to create a mini earthquake. The whole place shake for about 5 seconds. He looks at his fist in awe. He cannot believe he was able to transform from a weak, quirkless guy to a guy with strength and ability to fly. He looked at his fist and said, yes, now I can complete my goal and become the number one hero. But guys, I'm gonna end here. If you want to see the next part of this, just tell me what you think down in the comment of this what if. And like and subscribe. Comment down below. Turn that bell notification and stay posted, guys. And I really need your feedback and tell me what you think of this. But for now, guys, I'm out. Peace.